Please welcome former NABJ President and WSB AM 750 and 95.5 FM News Talk, Assistant Program Director Candace Presley.
Well, good evening, everyone. It is a special privilege for me to greet all of you tonight. For the last time NABJ met in Orlando 12 years ago, I was honored to begin my service to all of you as president of our organization. Tonight, my purpose is to lead us in tribute as we say thank you to the 19th president of the National Association of Black Journalists, my colleague and my friend, Gregory Hampton Lee, Jr. People, purpose, passion all add up to the power of NABJ and describe Greg Lee. Greg Lee is a man who is all about the people. I mean, I believe that Greg actually knows his more than 10,000 Facebook friends and Twitter followers. And if you've ever had the chance to spend time with him, you know that he is genuinely a nice guy who is well-liked by both men and women. Greg is well-liked and well-respected because he is a man of purpose. Now, Greg looks much younger than he really is. And early on in our friendship, I wondered, who is this serious young man? Then I met his family, many of whom are in the room with us tonight, the men and the women who loved him and instilled in him the belief that to whom much is given, much is required. Now, that is why throughout his career, he has continued to lead the Sports Task Force and the Sports Journalism Institute, and to give his time and to teach at the University of Maryland and Xavier. It was Greg's idea to take Sheila Brooks's baby, NABJ TV, and package it with The Monitor, the NABJ Radio Project, and the Online Student Project into SEED, Student Education Enrichment and Development. His purpose is in developing our people, especially our students. Now, Greg's passion, of course, is sports. Everything he has done in his NABJ service always finds some way to sports. In NABJ, he has found the path to connecting his two passions into growing diversity in the field of sports journalism. While the new recruiting buzz phrase speaks to bringing a diversity of thought into the editorial meeting, it still begins with there being a diversity of bodies in the room. And Greg has long been the go-to resource for editors seeking to hire talented journalists of color. Gregory Hampton Lee, Jr., a genuine people person with a strong sense of purpose for the work that we do and passion for creating opportunity for others. NABJ's third youngest leader is a man with an old soul, and for that, we have been well served. Thank you for your service, President Lee.
News executives have gotten lazy and flat out don't care about diversity.
When I got to the Boston Globe in 2005, I didn't see a lot of people of color in the newsroom. But I remember walking by the sports department and this skinny guy walked up to me and immediately said, "Welcome to the Globe." And it was Greg. And ever since then, he and I have been friends.
Greg Lee has always been a leader. I remember when he worked here at the Post, he would organize these potluck dinners for the young journalists on staff. They would get together and talk about their careers and their lives. And although I wasn't young enough to be invited to these events, I was still very happy and very proud and thought it was a great thing for them to do and a great thing for Greg to initiate. He served NABJ well in the national press.
I got news for you, companies that are ignoring diversity. We see you and we're coming after you.
I think what you did is now set the organization on a great path, has steadied things from where it was.
You're still going to be doing a great job in the world of sports journalism, where you continue to help guide and mentor young journalists and older journalists, too. And we are appreciative of that. And I'm sure your contributions to NABJ and the Sports Task Force will go on, too.
From one ex-president to a soon-to-be ex-president, well done, Greg. Thank you very much. Now, go get your life back.
But now that you have more time on your hands, I'm worried. I'm worried for your writers and your copy editors at the Sun Sentinel. You're going to be annoying them. But really, I think what your extra time on your hands, what you really need to go back to do is what you do best. Just root for the New Orleans Saints.
After this convention, get some rest. Go to one of those beaches in Miami and get a tan, man. You really need a tan.
I'm still excited that I see our organization still in growth, and I'm excited by our future.
Get up off of that thing! And you better get up off of that thing!
Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for the newest member of NABJ's Black History Club, President Gregory Hampton Lee.
Good evening, NABJ friends and family. Thank you very much for that warm welcome. Well, this is it. My final address as president of this organization we know and we call in love, the National Association of Black Journalists. I should really call this a thank you card because there are many thank yous and there's so many people I want to thank. If I listed them all, we'd be here all night. So I'll say in advance, I'll apologize if I don't list your name, but I'm thinking, you know, my heart just, there's so many people I don't want to thank, but I'm thankful to all of you guys. I want to first thank all my family who traveled here from New Orleans to see me ride into NABJ's NABJ Leadership Sunset. Without them, I would not be standing in front of you today. Like my brother Gabriel and his family who are here, my sister and his Caprice and her family here, my second family, Cliff and Pam Eugene, who I've known since I was 5 years old. They've came here from New Orleans to see me through here. But more importantly, my parents, Gregory and Charlene Lee. Yeah. In May, they celebrated their 40th anniversary. They met in the 9th Ward in New Orleans as teenagers. They are best friends. They're in the early 60s, and they act like teenagers. But I know one thing from my mom. And she says this to me, now that I have NABJ behind me, it's time for you to get married and bring me some more grandbabies. My response to her is that you can't even handle the 4 energetic grandchildren you have surrounding you now. So God help you if I got to add to that zoo. But I want to thank all of my supporters of over the years. Again, there are too many to name, but you know who you are. You've been there since day one. And for me, I want to thank all the committee chairs I appointed to help me out during these 2 years. Your service to NABJ has been just very valuable and not overlooked. And I want to thank the chair of the convention, Carol Ash, and program chair, Benay Wilson, and their committees. It takes a ton of work, gray hairs, and I've gotten some over the last couple of years because you guys, a lot of lost sleep to pull off something this big. So I want to stand up and give them a thank you and a round of applause. I wish to thank my presidential predecessors. Only those who have held this office of president can truly know what it is the challenges that we face as presidents. I'd like to thank them for leading this organization and making my job just a little easier. And like for all the former presidents to stand up, I recognize you guys. I also want to thank my board of directors during these past 2 years. I know that we had an intense run at times. I do know that we will learn and grow from these experiences, good and bad. To paraphrase an old saying, leadership is when others follow. Otherwise, it's just a walk alone. I'd like for you to stand up and take a bow. Thank you very much. I also want to thank the hardworking staff of the National Association of Black Journalists who have worked hard to make this week possible. And I know you guys weren't around, but I want to say thank you guys. You worked really well this week, and I really, really appreciate you, led by our Executive Director, Maurice Foster. Ladies and gentlemen, when I was elected president of NABJ in Philadelphia, I became the first sports journalist to hold this office. That was a very big deal to me. There were a lot of stereotypes and barriers about sports journalists. We were known as the toy department. Today, we're in a world where sports has become a dominant part of our lives. Sports is simply a microcosm of society. As a whole, sports journalists are not just trained to observe what is on the field, but what is off the field too as well. The difference is that we just look like we're having more fun doing it. I want to acknowledge those who started the path that I am on today. First of all, Larry Whiteside, who basically put together today's task force with his famous blacklist. I would like to thank Leon Carter and Sandy Rosenbluth, my mentors for almost 20 years, for having the foresight to form the Sports Journalism Institute 20 years ago at the NABJ convention in Detroit. We celebrated that anniversary here at NABJ. It is one of the best journalism insurance programs in America because not only it opened many doors for us where the doors were glued shut, but it's also provided a family of which I am grateful to have. I'm also going to give a shout out to the Sports Task Force, absolutely the best task force in the association. Yes, I am biased. But this group for 26 years has grown together as a family with one common goal, to have each other's back and pick up each other. Chair people like Whiteside, Ron Thomas, Leon Carter, Gary Howard, Roxanne Jones, and now Mark Spears, and other leaders such as Mike Terry, David Squires, and Uncle Justice Hill have been the voices that kept us grounded. We've come a long way. The task force has become one of the major revenue streams for this organization. Of course, it has the biggest after-hours event and hosting 8 scholarship jams. And I know you broke a sweat out last night at House of Blues. But we have come a long way, but we still have a long way to go. I'm only one of 4 African-American sports editors in newspapers around the country. My friends, as we approach the next board term, we are approaching another milestone for NABJ. This next board team will lead NABJ into its 40th anniversary. We must and will continue the fight, just like what our NABJ founders who started this fight for us in 1975. So I want to salute our founders. For those founders, I want them to stand up once again. I want to say thank you. Thank you on behalf of this organization. Thank you for your vision. Thank you for your convictions. And thank you for bringing us together here in Orlando in 2013. You have done a lot of work for our organization, but we still have a lot of work to do. So give our founders a round of applause. As I said, NABJ has done a lot over the years, but we still face many challenges, internally and externally. We are at a crossroads as we enter that 40th anniversary. Internally, we had to have a long conversation on where our organization is headed within its leadership. Bob Butler and the new board now has that challenge. We need that challenge to ourselves, to perhaps question the way NABJ conducts its business. We did some of that yesterday at that marathon 4-hour business meeting on Friday, but it was a great one. We must be more aggressive with our biggest external challenge, though, that is ensuring black journalism remains relevant. We have to match and best the chess moves of network executives who took a page out of the playbook from sports broadcast executives. In sports, they hired ex-athletes to fill their airways. What are cable networks doing today? They are hiring black policymakers and advocates, not trained journalists like we have in our organization. The game has changed, and we need to find a new strategy. We need to focus our efforts on that. We need to figure out on ways to do that and think bold, and perhaps put our money with the experts so we can have the cheddar to fund our advocacy efforts, so we can make sure we can get our fair shake in this industry. Over the past 15 years, I have dedicated myself to that ideal, ensuring our members get their fair shake. I will continue to do that, but from another platform. As tomorrow, I will be Black History on the NABJ Board of Directors. It has been an honor and privilege to be your leader for the past 2 years, and I'll always be a believer in NABJ. I love NABJ, and thank you, and God bless the National Association of Black Journalists.
Please welcome Beverly Nicholson Doty, Commissioner of Tourism for the U.S. Virgin Islands, for a special tribute to President Greg Lee.
Good evening, NABJ. President Lee, on behalf of the U.S. Virgin Islands, it is my honor to present you with this special gift that was made just for you by a woodmaster on the island of St. John, Avalino Samuel. Thank you for the partnership with the U.S. Virgin Islands.
I don't know. I'm trying to figure out because I read the program and the script is different. Do I do my President's Award now? Okay, because it's not in the script. Just making sure. The President's Award goes to a member of NABJ that goes above and beyond the call of duty. Tonight, we will have two winners that embodies the true spirit of service in NABJ. I would say this would be a sort of old school and new school combination. The first award, I will start with the new school. This member called me last year and said, Greg, I want to step up in NABJ. I want my task force to be better than the sports task force. I said, whoa. First of all, no one can touch the sports task force. But I said, I will give you the tools to succeed and help you along the way to make this work for you. Last year, this person worked very hard to secure a very successful reception featuring Hollywood stars such as Kerry Washington. This year, this person brought in several more stars, but more importantly, bringing more sponsors to NABJ, including one for $50,000 from Toyota Avalon. This person is not a professional fundraiser. This person just wants to serve and contribute to our organization. I consider her my friend. I consider her as an example to each of you what you can do. So Kelly L. Carter, come on down and get your President's Award. The second award goes to someone who does not want any spotlight, does not want any special treatment, does not want to be nominated for any awards. Yet, this person is very special. I can call this person for counsel when I needed it. When there is something I need, I will call this person. When she asks to speak to make a request of me, I make myself available because this person has done so much for this organization. She is a founder of this organization. She continues her work with this organization and running its founders task force. This person also runs our wonderful Hall of Fame, of which she does not want to be nominated for, but I'm sure some board would just put her in. This person is none other than Maureen Bunyan.